In this field, not only they grow the crop, such as the wheat, potato, also they have Kelowna as well. That also the you know, the raising the some cattle. You will see the lots of cattle. So I will tell you in the Alberta beef is number one, ranking as 3A in the North America. So I didn't know the how many days you will stay in the Rocky Mountain or in the Calgary. You should try the steak someday, because the Alberta beef is really, really good. However, the quality of the meat is good, but the chef always overcooked. So when you order the steak, you need to think about the way you cook. Now you can see it's Rocky Mountain, it's closer. This Rocky Mountain is a major mountain range in the western of North America. In summertime, right now you see all the snow covered on the top. In summertime, the snow is all melted, so showing only the very rock. So that's why the Rocky Mountain also known as the Rockies. It does stretch 4,800 kilometers in straight line distance from the northernmost part of the British Columbia, which is our neighbor. area is another provincial park named the Kananaskia Country. And 5 years ago, there is one Oscar movie, Revenant. Not sure that, have you seen that? This movie took a feature here. Ago, all the rock is under the ocean, and when they falls up, I would say the 96% of the rock is sedimentary, which is sandstone, shale, and limestone. This one is elk. Right now we are into the Banff National Park. This national park is the first one in Canada, established in 1885, and it is second one in North America. So which one is the first one? Is anybody know? No idea? Yellowstone. Yellowstone is the first one in North America, established in 1872, and this is the Banff National Park. Found that historical building, that one is Banff National Park office site. try this one, Castle Light Hotel. It's a Fairmont Hotel in the Banff. The name is Banff Spring Hotel. That is our last stop. So after that, when I take you back to the Calgary, we're looking at around 5, probably 6 o'clock. Sounds good?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I hope the traffic is more smoothly than the weekend. Arrived at Calgary on time. Right now we're passing this railway, which is very famous in western of Canada. The name is Canadian Pacific Railway. This railway building in 19th century. And lots of the contribution by the Chinese people. You also can see the on the surface of the bridge, they are all planted. So Canadian also call that one as the green bridge. Green, yes. Yeah, green. Why Canadian want to build that bridge for the animal? Because you can see, yeah. Yes, to improve the some safety for this highway, the traffic. Because the you can see the this highway number one is all crossing. This highway number one is the longest route in Canada. It is transcontinental. It also known as the Trans-Canada. So coast to coast, to from the Pacific Ocean to the Atlantic Ocean. Both end, west end is Victoria, which is capital city of the British Columbia. And then the east end is St. John's, capital city of Newfoundland. Total length is 8,000. Kilometer. So it's longest route, and this highway number one were all crossing the Rocky Mountain. And then as I mentioned today, weather forecast in the morning is all the like this one, heavy snow. But in afternoon it will become the raining as well, because the temperature will went up. Yes. So we will see, maybe in afternoon when you arrive at Lake Louis, you can. And right now you can see the slope is very steep, and also the those the railway will cross in this Rocky Mountain area as well. So for those so heavy the cargo train, how did they